So I just got off a coaching call with a Dutch coaching student, and we talked about high ticket clients, and I'm not going to name any names, but he couldn't get his head around the fact that you can charge 2k upwards to 5k a month for social media marketing. So basically in the Netherlands, in fact it's roughly the same around all of Europe, in the Netherlands, if you work full time, if you work 40 hours a week, you know, at a high end job, you get paid roughly 2,000 to 2,500 a month for, you know, working full time basically. And he just could not understand that you can actually earn that in under an hour a day by setting up Facebook ads for social media marketing clients. And basically what you need to understand is that people that work in an office job that are doing administrative tasks on the computer are replaceable, whereas you know, people that do Facebook ads, people that can set up online funnels, you know, they are much more so the skill is much more high ticket, it's much more of a high income skill, and it's not as easily replaceable. So if I am working at a desk job 40 hours a week, I'm answering emails, I'm doing all kinds of administrative tasks, and I say to my boss, listen, you know, I don't think it's worth it, I don't think I am, you know, the money is worth working 40 hours a week, and I quit, then, you know, within a week he can find someone else to do that job, you know, for him, and do the exact same job, replicate the exact same performance and results as I was doing. Whereas with Facebook ads, that is much more difficult. That is why Facebook ads is basically much more high ticket. You can charge much, much more. Plus, you can also earn the client or the business much, much more. So there's only so much you can do, you know, doing the administration and answering emails at a desk job, you know, for a company. Whereas if you can help businesses, you know, generate more leads, generate more sales, you know, that is much more valuable for that business. So in terms of how to actually land a 2K a month client or charge 2K a month for your service, what I highly recommend doing, especially when starting out, because it can be quite difficult to get your first 2K a month client, is finding a warm introduction or referral. So finding someone that can vouch for you on your behalf, you know, someone that can either come with you to the meeting, or someone that can say, listen, you know, I know this guy, I can vouch for him, I guarantee you this guy will do a good job for you. Okay, so let's say, you know, you're here, client A is here, try and find a middleman, so someone that can basically, someone that the client trusts and someone that you trust as well, someone that can basically bring you guys together and say to you, say to the client, you know, this guy can do a really good job for you. Okay, so a warm referral, warm introduction, that is, in my opinion, when it's your first 2K a month client, that is an absolute must. Second thing that I'd like to say is, with clients like this, with the more high ticket clients, which if you're just starting out, you know, 2K a month is relatively high ticket, it won't be a one call or a one meeting close, okay? It's gonna be really difficult to close that person on your first meeting, your first get together, now whether that is face to face or via Skype or via Zoom, it's gonna be really difficult to do that in one go. More often than not, the first call or the first meeting will be a discovery call. So you ask, you know, questions, you know, you try and get more information about the business, and then the follow-up call or meeting, that is when you actually go in for the close. Okay, so let's say you've got a meeting on Monday, then like I said, you know, 99.9% of the time that first meeting will just be a discovery meeting, and then the client will, you know, say like, okay, well, can you send a proposal, or, you know, can you draft up some kind of strategy or blah, blah, blah. And what you need to do then is schedule another call or meeting, preferably for that week as well, because then you're still top of mind. You know, if you're going to schedule a meeting for a month later, or, you know, somewhere down the line, it's going to be really hard for that person to, you know, remember all the value you brought in the first meeting. So try and get that second meeting in the same week. So if it's Monday, try and schedule that meeting for either Wednesday or Friday. Okay, Friday people are more relaxed, but be careful with Fridays, because people are sort of edging towards the weekend, you know, they're already mentally back home, you know, chilling and stuff like that. So make sure that you do get that person at the right time. And in the time in between Monday and Friday, if the meeting is on Friday, just follow up with them constantly. You know, send Loom, send videos. If you've got like a free PDF or something or portfolio, send it over, send them messages. You know, make sure that you stay top of mind with that client. Okay, so like I said, warm referral, then try and get the it's basically like a two call close. And then thirdly, what you need to do is work out what the return on investment is going to be for the client. Okay, so for example, if it's if you're talking to a hairdresser that has just a regular male barbers that charges £10 for a haircut, it's going to be really difficult to charge £2,000 a month for that, because you know, if you're charging £2,000 a month, just work out how many extra customers he needs to get for £10 each to even break even with your retainer. You know, it's going to be really difficult. Whereas if you're doing social media marketing and you're charging £2,000 to like a high-end dentist that, you know, installs those braces, you know, one client for them is £5,000 to £8,000. So, you know, you can immediately, with one client, one extra customer, you can earn that client your retainer back. So that is the way you need to think about it. You need to make sure that you can get that return on investment for the client and make sure that it makes sense for that client to take you on as an agency. Okay, so that is all I've got for today. Like I said, guys, warm introduction, two call close, follow up daily, send as much value to them as possible, and make sure that you work out that return on investment for them and that you can prove to them that that investment in you makes sense. Okay guys, so like the video if you got something out of it, comment down below what you'd like to see from my channel next, subscribe to the channel for more, and I'll see you guys in the next one.